to another edition of Johnny D's TV. Tonight we're here with Mike Doucet of the internationally known group Beausoleil. It's good to have you here.
Good, it's good to be here.
How are
you doing?
You doing alright?
Look like relaxed, huh? Look like you're talking about all that dancing.
Yeah. So where did the name Beausoleil come from?
Where did the name Beausoleil come from? That's a really long story. How long you say this interview is? Like 3 minutes? Make a long, long story short. Basically, our ancestors were the original Acadians. They came from what is now Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and parts of Maine. They were there from the French settlers basically moved to the New World as early as 1604. And they lived in this area, what they call Acadia, then they were obviously called Acadians. Until the English really wanted their lands, you know, put a Walmart and all that stuff on it. And so they did that, and they deported the Acadians, about 10,000 of them, in 1755 it began. One of the resistance leaders was a relative of ours. His name was Joseph Broussard, and his nickname was D. Beausoleil. That's where the name came about. He was one of the last resistance fighters. He was, again, you know, expelled also, and he ended up in Louisiana. He had a family there. One of his sons built a house, so that was in like the 1790s or early 1800s, which stayed in the family. So our family would have these big, huge family reunions, about 150 people. We'd go to this house and we'd call it Beausoleil. So it was all this story that I've heard, you know, from growing up. And then back in 1976, we were just a group of young kids playing this music, and we were asked to play and perform in France. 2 weeks and you know, on the French shore, they needed a name. We don't have a name. You must have a name. I said, we don't have a name. What's your name? I said, well, Beausoleil. Oh, beautiful. So that's how it began.
You guys are based out of Lafayette, Louisiana.
Lafayette Parish, yeah.
And how are things going down there?
Oh, after the hurricane? Well, yeah. You know, I mean, it's been 2 years. Lafayette was spared. We had a bad one about 4 years ago that knocked a lot of electricity out for a week. And you just have that. I mean, it's part of the deal. What happened in the last one, I mean, Katrina hit mostly New Orleans. Then a month after that, Rita hit southwest Louisiana, more towards Texas. And those people are still suffering because Katrina got all the news, even though they didn't get all any of the money. People who were hit with Rita didn't get anything. But I mean, everybody just bounces back. I mean, you just do that. We've noticed a lot more people in Lafayette. I think they have maybe some 30 to 40,000 more people.
Have been around for about 30 years now. You've traveled all over the world. You're known as like the grandfather of Cajun music.
Don't start that. Not a grandfather yet.
How has your style changed throughout the years?
Well, the hope has gotten better. Mm-hmm. I had the chance to study and meet a lot of the incredible pioneers of Cajun music. Now, we call Cajun pioneers the first people to record. Now, they weren't people who had like record contracts. It was mostly because of the people like RCA Victor wanted to sell Victrolas to people. So they go out and have these contests where whoever won that, they would make a 78 RPM. And then they would go out to these little towns and say, don't you want to hear this guy? Boom. And so those people, the golden age, I would call it, of Cajun music, it was the first time it was recorded, documented, was back in 1928 to basically happened about until 1936. So that's the kind of style that I really like. Well, I was lucky enough to meet some of the people that have recorded back then, Sadie Coraville, Dennis McGee, just incredible, Leo Swallow, just people who carried this history from like the 1900s, actually the 1800s into the 1900s, people have seen airplanes for the first time, things like that. So it was just amazing to learn the roots of the music from these guys.
his shows, Late Night with Conan O'Brien, Emerald Live, Austin City Limits, and as you said before, Yatters and Healers, Cradle and Companion, which my parents and me are a huge fan. What was it like to be on these shows?
Well, it was always a, you know, surprise. Yeah, it's always fun. I mean, the first time we went on Prairie Home Companion was like in 1982. I didn't know what it was. We didn't ever get it. And it was like, we got there, I could tell you a short story again. It was January 15th, 1982, and they just had a snowstorm. And the old theater they were in, the World, the roof caved in. So they had to move to the Orpheum that same night. And so we got there, and you know, we, from Louisiana, and it was like, you know, 60 degrees in Louisiana over there, it's like 10 below zero. So these people are uptight, man. And we didn't realize what was going on. So we were kind of the calm in the storm. And I think it kind of just led on to everybody else, and Garrison really liked it. I think we played like 45 minutes that first night, which is an error. And then we developed a good relationship with him. And it was always fun. I mean, we'd done TV shows. I mean, Conan was hysterical. A tall guy, really funny. He's a lot more funnier in person than he is on TV. I think he's too tall for TV, you know? But I love him. He's great. And just a bunch of shows. I mean, Emerald's a trip. And, you know, all those things that happen. It's just, it's nice things that they happen, but it's just, you know, serendipitous. It's not that we look out for it.
What's up next for Bus LA?
What's next? Johnny T's here. For some reason, we've been involved in doing a lot of different solo projects. You know, we've done a lot of records and running Grammys, so it's, for me, it's like, that's what I'm doing. It's like, I have records, kind of a jazz record with some New Orleans jazz groups. It's going to be on R. Hooley Records, and then I did a solo record with the Smithsonian, and that should be out next year, and that's everything from, you know, Mitchell and I, Mitchell Reed playing twin fiddles, and me playing just solo violin and singing, and me playing with another guitar player, some kind of thing. So I don't know, you know, whatever comes up, whatever feels good. But we have like so many records. I mean, we finished the record 2 years ago. We started working on the record and we never finished it. And so that's still in the can. So I don't know what we're gonna do with that one. You know, like 2 years ago, I was like, man, I don't remember what I played 2 years ago. So I mean, there's always stuff, so it's still fun.
Well, thanks for stopping by, Mike.
All right.
It's a pleasure to have you.
Nice to be in the dungeon with you.
Yeah. We'll see you again.
All right.